Fuck!
Come on!
9, 7, 6, 5, 4, get it, 3, 2, 1, 1 rep, come on, 8, flex, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go again, here we go, 7, yeah, again, here we go, more. Nine. One more. Rest. Up. Down. Already up. There you go. There we go. Let's go. You're fine. Yep.
All right, Jenny. So I want to talk about another return of yours to the stage. And by this time, it's probably like your third career in fitness, right?
Yeah.
So tell me why you decided to stop after the last string of competing. So you did, you don't, you one time, but twice in 18, 19?
Yeah.
At 18, 19, you went back to the Olympia for the eighth time, and then you took a little break again. So tell me what happened.
I did the Arnold, and then, so that was right at, during COVID.
Ah,
so that took me out of the game.
Okay.
Not working, you know, lost, what, 10 months of business or whatever it was.
Wow.
So I had to rebuild again, start rebuilding. The gym shut down. I had to end up finding another location to work in. So I had to spend, 3 years building the business back.
Wow.
So it was good because it was a blessing because we got the Genergy Jump outdoors, and we were able to do that during COVID, and I was able to do Zoom Genergy Jumps. So I really just focused on the Genergy Jump and building the routines and creating the whole program. So by this time, at the end of 2022, I saw something that they were going to have the first ever Fitness Masters Olympia. And I was like, yes, like that has my name all over it. So I was like, I don't want to lose the opportunity to become part of history by doing the first ever Fitness Masters Olympia. And so when I heard about it, I knew I had a long ways to go. And I knew it was still a good, it was November when they released it, or December, until August. So I had to really transform my life again. I was just, you know, out drinking, living my best life that way. So I had to do a whole body transformation.
And now, if you don't mind, I'm going to ask you to give me some before pictures so people can see how much work you've actually done during that time, because that's really impressive, right?
Yeah.
So you were like not happy with yourself around that time. And like when it was like, you know, January and stuff, like you were just in a place where you didn't feel good, right?
Yeah. So, you know, doing the shows, like the fitness and the competing has always brought me back to a place of where it brings you to be a better person. You know, you're in a structured form. You're not out doing things you shouldn't be doing. So it really always just puts my life in a back into the right realm of where it needs to be, you know, on the right path. I always say it, fitness has always brought me in a good place and got my life back together. So, yeah, so I chose to put in my invite.
Now, let's talk about that too, because once I found out you were doing the Masters, I I said to you, oh my God, I really want to, I would really like to film you, you know, just reconnect and show the journey again. And then when the list came out, you were not on it. And so I was like, oh my God, she's not, they didn't pick her. And I was so disappointed for you. So we kind of just never filmed before the show because I didn't think you were going to do it.
Yeah.
What happened?
What happened was same thing that happened with the Arnold. They just didn't see my name. They didn't see my email. Once again, I was like, man, maybe they don't like me anymore.
You fell through the cracks?
Yeah. Fell through the cracks again. So as soon as the list came out, I messaged Dan, like I always do. I'm like, hey, can you just like let me know, maybe give me some insights of why I didn't make it on the list? And I messaged Steve Weinberger, and it wasn't even 30 minutes later, I got a phone call from both of them. They're like, what do you mean? They didn't get your application. I was like, no, I put it in. They were like, of course we want you there. So I went through the cracks again, and I didn't get on the list. They didn't announce it. I'm like, that's fine. I don't need to be on the list. I know I'm on the list. And with you, I told you I was going to, you know, I was doing it, and I was going to come to train with Milos.
Yes.
And then I pulled my rotator cuff, so I wasn't even training. I couldn't train from March. That happened in March. I was trying to do fitness moves at 160 pounds when I shouldn't have been doing one-arm freezes yet. And yeah, I pulled my rotator cuff. So that took me out of training. It took me out of routine practice. So what was I left with? I was left with jumping, twerking, and just like blasting my butt on the booty belt with the EMS training.
Like all the stuff that you're putting on Instagram. So I thought in my head, I'm thinking, she's doing the training, she's doing like the routine, and she's doing all this other stuff extra. I'm thinking like, this is all you do like all day, but I guess you couldn't do anything else.
No, I didn't start. Every time I would go to lift weights, it would re-injure it. So then I was 10 pounds is all I could do, bands. And then I was having my neck problems that I have, bulging discs in my neck that are like 7 millimeters. They were flared up. Wow. So I really with my hands tied behind my back, I couldn't do anything. But people were like, why are you still going to do it? I'm like, because I want to be a part of history. No matter if I win, lose, whatever it is, at the end of the day, I'm still making history. So I got the stem cell done 4 weeks before the show. And I was already doing the routine practice, but I was leaving out. I couldn't do a lot of, it was 2 days, and then I was out for five. It would throw me out, so I have to take a break. So I did the stem cell, and that helped out. Thank God, 2 weeks before the show, I was like, Milos, I don't know what I'm going to do. I can't do a backflip. Should I just wait and do it there? I haven't done any flips since the Arnold. So like a week before, I was able to do some flips. I found a gymnastics center, and I did them. So I was like, okay, I did like 2 weeks of routine practice. And I was already doing the routine practice on hardwood floor, but I wasn't doing the flips, just the push-ups, the one-arm freezes. And I'm used to doing those all week, every day, 7 days a week. And I was limited to doing them twice a week, only about 10 to 20 rounds of them. And I'm used to drilling them more than that. So the training was a little bit different.
So how did you feel like mentally going to the Olympia, not knowing that you couldn't even train and stuff? Did you, because you still finished fourth. You finished first in a routine round, and that routine was outstanding. I think you finished like eighth in physique, right?
Yeah, like correct. Second to last.
Yeah. Oh, is that right?
Yeah,
really?
There's nine of us. So, yeah.
So you still finished in fourth. How was your confidence going into the show? Not that I would have been able to, I mean, your condition was great, but
I knew that my symmetry wasn't real there. I didn't have the roundness. I knew that I was going to lack in. So I was like, I just got to give the best performance of my life.
Yeah.
That's what I have to do.
Yeah.
Whatever I do, I have to give the best performance of my life. And I just prayed on that. And I asked God to just help me get through this performance and get the best performance of my life. And so that pulled me out and forth. And so, yeah, I knew that I was going to not do very well in the physique round because I knew the way I looked. People were like, did you get feedback from the judges? I'm like, no, I don't need feedback. I can look in the mirror and see what I need to do.
Yeah.
So we're here now, right? And after the Olympia, I took 2 weeks off. I did the stem cell. My shoulder was feeling amazing. You know, I have the torn rotator cuff and the torn ACL. It was kind of flared up and went back down. And my client, Lauren's like, are you going to do the Legions? I'm like, why would I do that? And I was like, wait a second. You know what? My shoulder feels good. I think I can start lifting. So I was like, if I can pull the body up and do the routine, it's still placed really high in the routine.
Yeah.
Maybe I have a chance, you know? I'm trying to get back to the Olympia stage.
Yes. So here we are. We're about 3 weeks out right now from the Legion. We're hoping for a first place over there. So you can, because if you win that, you can go straight to the Olympia in Florida, which would be great, obviously. And that would be your 10th.
Yeah, trying to get to 10. Yeah. Well, 9 plus the Masters.
Yeah, well, still Olympia. Yeah. Awesome. Wow, what a journey you have. And I wanted to talk about it a little bit because sometimes people see you guys on stage and they see the final product, but they don't have any idea of what you guys went through to get there. And I think the story, the journey is important for people to know. You know, so as great as you did at the Masters Olympia, I think you'll do even better at the Legion and hopefully end up back to the Olympia because I think you belong there. So congratulations and thank you. All right.